Hi, my name is Kevin Taylor. Today I'm going to tell you why the NPP government is scared of election 2020. This is With All Due Respect. Hi, with all due respect, today I'm going to have a talk with the NPP. Yes, as an NPP member, I have decided to have this talk with the NPP as a government and also as a political party. The honest truth is, the NPP, as I speak, is scared of the 2020 elections. Why do I say that? I say this because, one, we have failed the people. Two, what we told the people we were going to do, we are doing the opposite. It is simple, my fellow NPP sympathizers. It is simple, the NPP government. The issue is that now, the things we talked about in opposition, we are actually doing the opposite. We can't create jobs. The amount of debt we came to inherit, my fellow Ghanaians, we have made it worse in this short time. Yes, less than 3 years. The people we say we're going to prosecute when we were in opposition, today, where are those people? We set up a toothless bulldog called the special prosecutor. This guy. He has even spent more money than the money we were thinking of chasing. Yes, we have spent so much money on this guy than the money we were expecting to get from Wyoming and Opuni. My fellow Ghanaians, my fellow NPP sympathizers, let's face the facts. The NPP as a political party now has failed. Yes, we have failed when it comes to employment. We have failed when it comes to education. We have failed when it comes to industrialization, creation of jobs, housing. In fact, Ghana, as I speak, my fellow NPP, you people know that is a failed state. I know you people put up a very strong face. You come on TV, you sit on radio, you hit on your chest, you put up this face. But behind closed doors, you know that what I'm saying is the truth. The people are watching. We have failed the people. Today, as we speak, corruption is a big tag on the NPP. The Kufuor NPP wasn't like that. The Edubuahen NPP wasn't like that. Today, one thief is transferred from one office to the other, thinking that the ordinary Ghanaian will forget. A thief like Pius Heze from the Sports Ministry, a criminal, has been moved to the Information Ministry. This guy, every serious scandal that has hit this government has had the president's name attached to it. Today, the NPP is even more corrupt than the alleged cases we made in opposition. Yes, I know that people don't want to hear this, but the honest truth is, the youth in Ghana today who were waiting for the NPP to give them jobs or create jobs for them are very angry. They are angry because they are beginning to realize that we lied to them. Everybody knows that NAPCO was a lie. It was a political gimmick. Nothing is happening. Planting for food and jobs. Another concert party. My fellow Ghanaians, especially my fellow NPP, let us face the fact and tell Ghanaians what we can do and what we can do. Let us humble ourselves and be honest with the ordinary Ghanaian. Today, ordinary Ghanaians are even scared to go to bed because the security in this nation is zero. Ordinary people can't even walk on the streets without being kidnapped. Other countries are putting out statements that their citizens who are in Ghana should be careful. Yes, that's what we're seeing. Countries are putting out statements telling people that Ghana is a no-go zone under the rule of the New Patriotic Party. This is absurd. All the noise we made today when it rains for 10 minutes, just 10 minutes, people start to panic. People die in Accra because we can't clean the city. The government has no idea how to manage the city. The cleanliness the president talked about, today he's not even talking about it again. We were in the same country, my fellow Ghanaians. NPP, let's be honest with ourselves. We have failed. If elections were to be held today, we know, NPP, my fellow NPP sympathizers, if John Mahama was paired with Akufo-Addo today in Ghana, John Mahama would win. Not because John Mahama is an extraordinary candidate. It's because what John Mahama did, the kind of legacy John Mahama left, we have not been able to let Ghanaians know that we can even live to half of their expectations. These are honest truth. We can play all the dilly-dallies, we can all play the gimmicks, political statements, propagandas. The things John Mahama was able to build wasn't John Mahama's money. Those were our monies. So if you come, if we are in power, and if you fail, we fail to even open these things to the people, to ask Ghanaians to use these facilities, then at the end of the day, the people will feel like you are rather the problem, not the John Mahama you are blaming. Yes, I know. Today, if somebody's nose is bleeding, it's going to be this guy, John Mahama. Why is the debt getting to 200 million? It's John Mahama. Why is Accra being flooded? Why are people dying? It's the same John Mahama. Why is there no jobs? Why can't we create more jobs? It's John Mahama. At the end of the day, we, the NPP, are making John Dramani Mahama powerful than even the sitting president. It's a fact. It is so shocking that a president who just left office, the people didn't like because of the things we said, is even more popular than the sitting president. It should worry each and every NPP sympathizer. I am an NPP man. I would love to see the NPP in power for 20, 50 years. But what we are seeing now is a joke. Trust me. I know this is a very tough thing for any ordinary NPP or a diehard NPP person to take in. But the honest truth is, if elections were held today, as an NPP member, I will tell you, John Dramani Mahama will win. And he will win not because Ghanaians are stupid. He will win because Ghanaians this time will vote with their brains, not their thumb. My fellow Ghanaians, let's be honest with ourselves. The NPP as a political party has failed totally. We have failed the people. When you go on the streets, people are getting mad each and every day. Go on social media. I know we won this election, the 2016 election, on social media. There were a lot of things on social media I can't even talk about. We saw how Mahama's houses and hotels popped up on social media, the billion-dollar mansions. After the election, everything just dried out. We know how every week we're being told that billions of gold were carried to Dubai by Mahama and his brothers. After the election, everything went away. We talked about Wyoming. It went away. Today, we are not talking about anything. Was it that we lied to the people? We made up stories? Are we now facing the realities? The NPP, let's be honest with ourselves. If elections was held today, this gentleman, John Dramani Mahama, would defeat our candidate, Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo. That is if even Akufo-Addo decides to run. Let's be honest with ourselves. The road, the streets, the ground is not fertile for us. Let us be honest with ourselves. Tell the people the truth. We are struggling as the government. We are struggling as a political party. The people who are leading us are misleading us. Corruption has been the talk of the day. Our president cannot walk over corruption. He always has to step in it. This is an insult. This is how low the NPP party has come. I am not here to make the NPP feel bad. There's still room for improvement. How many years have we done? 2.5, 3 years? We can still build the thousands of schools we promised. The 1 million, one constituency, we can do it. The one district, one dam. The thousands and thousands of promises we told Ghanaians we were going to do. Are we sure? My fellow Ghanaians, my fellow MPP, Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, are you sure that you can accomplish this? We know government is progressive. That's why every Ghanaian was telling that when he came to power, we were supposed to continue whatever John Dramani Mahama had started. The schools, the hospitals, the airports, you know, the chip compounds, the industries he left behind, we were supposed to finish. The roads, you know, but what did we do? We forgot about that word, progressive, continuation. We decided to start things to please ourselves and to please the ignorant Ghanaian who is selfish and does not think about us. But you know the funny thing? We will get some liars, some big-head individuals who wear some Vietnam suits, come stand on TV and speak good English, go on radio, pay their way and tell Ghanaians lies. But my fellow Ghanaians, my fellow NPP, the people out there, they are feeling the heat. And trust me, to make the right decision if we don't change our ways. If elections were held today, I'm going to say this again, The NDC would defeat the NPP. I'm speaking as an NPP member. I'm not scared to say this because I can see the glimpses of that. The people are getting wise. They are realizing that we lied to them. The funny thing is, we ourselves are so much into corruption than the corruption we are thinking of investigating. We are so corrupt as a political party or as a party in government than the people we want to investigate. It is so funny that you are a thief and you want to investigate a thief. With all due respect, my fellow NPP members, the time has come. I know a few people will be honest, come on TV or come on social media to say the truth. But I don't want to sound like a prophet of doom. What I can say is, I think that we may or we might lose the 2020 elections. I understand why we are getting so frustrated anytime elections are talked about, anytime issues about the EC is brought up. It is because we are scared. If we say that we won the 2016 election legitimately, we don't have to be scared about anything. And if we think the Electoral Commission is our only resort to win the 2020 elections, then we are making a big mistake. You know the reason? The people, when they want to take power from you, they will take it. It doesn't matter who helps you. If they want to take that power from you, they will take it because they gave you that power. And trust me, 2020, people are going to vote with their head, not their thumb. People are going to vote not because they belong to any political party. They are going to vote because they have come to realize the truth from the lies. What we are seeing now, the floods, the crisis with kidnapping, the unemployment, the housing problems, the debt deficit, all these things coming together, if we don't deal with them, trust me, we will be in opposition before we realize it. My name is Kevin Ekobedu Taylor, and this is With All Due Respect.